it is. We are now live on the Internet of Life.
Let's see here.
The Internet of Life.
Hello, everybody.
Tracy's going to see if it's showing up on her Facebook page because there were some issues with that.
Yeah, it's showing up as locked again. I don't know why.
All right, well, unlock it. Unlock that bad boy.
I'm going to unlock it. Unlock the magic.
All right.
If it'll let me. Edit audience.
All right, I'll try and do that reverb too. And we'll try and talk close to the microphone. All right, Hannah is here. Looking forward to the show. David, Dan, Steve, Bob Cole, our good buddy Bob Cole, Dan Unger. They're coming too fast. I can't read them all. Richard, Katrina, Liz, Ken Glasser from Maryland.
Everybody's
Ken.
Ken,
we're video buddies now, Ken and I.
Okay, here we go.
How are you doing over there? You got it?
Yeah, I had to go out and elsewhere.
You had to go out into the ether web and figure out what the heck was going on?
Let me just check Tracy Grammer Music now.
You're live on Facebook and the YouTube both.
Okay, nice. Everything looks good. There we go.
Steve, Linda's
there
here.
There we go.
All right.
Phew. Heavy lifting over here.
I know. Well, trying to get it right.
That's right. If you are joining us for a rebroadcast, if you're watching the archive, we welcome you as well. Of course, our shows are always, they always stay up after the show, so you can watch anytime.
Stay up after the show, that's just like me. I always stay up after the show.
Stay up after the show, yeah, you do. Get ourselves in tune here. I was in tune a minute ago. I don't know what happened. But how you doing over there, Jim Henry?
I'm okay.
Yeah?
I'm trying to get myself in tune. I was in tune a minute ago, too. Well, you know, the weather down here in the basement.
It's changed. It's gotten chilly down here. I feel a little...
I wouldn't say that's the case, but...
I'm cold.
Maybe you've got the coronavirus.
Oh, shh. I don't think it makes you cold, does it?
I don't know.
Neither of us have had it.
I know, that's crazy.
As far as we know. Well, today's show is called Sheroes, a word I secretly hate, actually. I hate that word. But the point is that we're singing songs by women songwriters, focusing on them, some who have influenced our careers from the beginning. Maybe even inspired us to become musicians, and some we picked up along the way, you know, newer to us. So, but for the most part, these guys are all classics, wouldn't you say?
I would say.
Yeah.
I would say. In the singer-songwriter world, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah, so I think I'm kicking it off. Is that right?
That's correct. That is correct.
All right. Well, we're going to start with none other than Kate Wolf.
She's a woman.
She sure was. Yeah. This is Across the Great Divide. Well, I've been walking in my sleep, counting trouble. Instead of counting the sheep, where the years went, I can't say. I just turn around and they're gone away. I've been sifting through the layers of dusty books and faded paper. Tell a story I used to know. It was one that happened so very long ago. It's gone away and yesterday. Now I find myself on the mountainside where the
connection across the great divide. Well, I heard the owl calling softly as the night was falling, with a question and I replied. Myself on a mountainside, where the rivers change direction across the great
Across the Great Divide. All right.
All right, stay. Really, we're doing this second, huh? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
We made the set list like 2 seconds before the broadcast went live. So
I know we were running lines before.
Yeah, Jim Henry was so kind. I've got a play rehearsal today. I don't know if you know this, but I got the acting bug now, and I got cast in a play called Marvin's Room, which is being offered by the Westfield Theater Group in October. And we're just off book this week. And I did really well on Sunday's rehearsal, but this second act I'm not so clear on. And I'm the lead. I have all the lines. So I was feeling twitchy. And so Jim Henry said, sit down, we're going to run some lines. He's like, I need you to not be such a freak.
Yeah, I know, I need you to calm the hell down.
Do you think I should play mandolin on this?
Whatever's going to rock the hardest is what you should play on this.
Well.
This is number 3 there, okay.
Let's try mandolin. Can I have it?
I kind of got it tuned up and ready for...
Oh, you have something else happening.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I mean,
let's see what we can do with this little number.
You could rock the guitar if you wanted to.
Oh, that's not going to happen.
Well, of course, when you mentioned Sheroes, you gotta have Gillian Welsh in there.
Now, this is from one from way back, wouldn't you say?
I would say.
A formative hero.
One of my favorites here. Elvis Presley Blues. Yet. love was thinking that night about Elvis. The day that he died, the day that he died. I was thinking that night about Elvis. The day that he died, yeah, the day that he died. He's just a country boy. He combed his hair and put on the shirt that his mother made, and it went on the air. And he shook it like a chorus girl. But he shook it like a Harlem queen. And he shook it like a midnight rambler, baby, like you never seen, you never seen, never seen. Well, I was thinking that night about Elvis, the day that he died, yeah, the day that he died. I was thinking that night about Elvis, yeah, the day that he died, the day that he died. That it took it all out of black and white. He grabbed it one in the other hand and he held on tight. And he shook it like a hurricane. He shook it like to make it break. He shook it like a holy roller, baby, with his soul at stake. His soul at stake. Yeah, soul at stake. All right, tear it up, Tracy. I was thinking that night about Elvis, the day that he died, oh, the day that he died. He was all alone in a long decline, thinking how happy John Henry was, and he lay down and died. He shook it and it rang like silver. He shook it and it rang like gold. He shook it and it beat that steam drill, baby. Well, bless my soul, what's wrong with me? Hey! That is
such a fun song, such a fun one.
I'm trying to turn this reverb off and it just keeps doing that,
keeps doing that reverb thing.
There we go.
All right. Oh my goodness. Gillian Welch.
Yeah, she's okay. Turns out she's pretty good.
Ron has a weakness for songs about Elvis.
Is that right?
But he doesn't like Elvis songs.
just about him.
Good thing we're not playing any today.
No. He didn't really write songs though.
He didn't write any?
I don't think so.
Really?
I don't think so.
Oh, that's kind
Maybe
of incredible.
Maybe one or two, but he was an interpreter.
Where did we decide to do this? Are we doing this on one? No, all right. Nothing like changing the key right before the show. All right.
I'm not using finger picks on this one, damn it.
You're not?
Nope.
What are you going to do?
I'm just using a flat pick.
Oh, a flat pick? I thought you were going to use your nails.
No.
Oh, Harry's here. Hey, Harry. Welcome. Glad you could make it. All right. So we got a lot of friends in the house today. I think we might have some new people in the house, too. I was just on tour in the Pacific Northwest. I went to Eugene and Portland and Bellingham. Felt really good to be back on stages again. Really good. I was surprised to learn how many people had been watching the live streams. They say, oh, yeah, I've been seeing that. A lot of people didn't know about him, so if you're here for the first time, welcome. This is what we do. It's very laid back. We just chit-chat and play songs. Every show has a theme. This time our show is, our theme is Sheroes, or women writers that we admire. And this next one is Dolly Parton. Dolly Parton is, I don't think I really appreciated her as a songwriter. I think I really came to her as a performer.
Yeah.
You know, like I didn't really understand what she wrote or what she didn't write until you and I did that tribute at the Parlor Room. Was that this year? Oh, God.
Yeah, it was this year, except it was in Greenfield. It wasn't at the Parlor Room.
Oh, that's right. It was at Hawks and Reed.
Yeah.
Yeah. And also, my friend Peggy had given me a book of Dolly Parton's songs as to inspire me. And I was like, all these? Really?
Yeah, she wrote a lot of stuff.
She's just always writing songs, you know, sitting in a waiting room, write a song about it. You know what I mean? She just, yeah,
she's
very prolific. So this one here it's cute in the way that country is cute. It's clever. This one is called The Grass is Blue. I've had to think of a way to survive since you said it's over and told me goodbye. I just can't make you one day without you unless I pretend the opposite's true. Rivers flow backwards, valleys are high, mountains are level, truth is. Dolly Parton, The Grass is Blue. It's very clever. Great chorus.
Yeah, it is a great
chorus. Wide open chorus. Love that.
Wait, that's the wrong way.
Wrong way. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, gosh. Thanks, Steve. Steve's like, maybe some people don't know where the tip jar is.
Oh, yeah.
There's yeah, that. We're not very good about that, are we? Let's see here if I can find it.
Put that tip jar up.
Yeah, so our live streams are always offered without a paywall, which means that you don't have to buy a ticket to see them. But, you know, we got a lot of lights in this room keep running. Jim Henry's electric bill spikes a little every time we do a live stream. So there it is, right on the bottom of your screen there. The tip jar information, all the tips obviously split 50-50 between Jim and me. Either by PayPal or Venmo. Venmo is still not charging a fee, so it works out a little better for us. But whatever's convenient for you, we appreciate it. And if you'd rather write a check, we'll put a link up for that. Put the information up that in a bit. What do you got for us, Jim Henry?
Oh, this is, of course, I did a stint playing with Mary Chapin Carpenter, and so I've always been a big fan of her stuff, and this is a great one. Of course, I always, when I hear this one, I always think of John Jennings, who played guitar for her and produced records for her,
and for me,
and for you, and for Tracy Grammer. And it's got this wonderful little guitar line that took me about 10 years to learn.
Don't mess it up then.
Yeah, no, I jinxed myself completely. but this is one you're probably familiar with. Hallie Comes to Jackson. One, two, three.
When the wind was still, well, Daddy brought the baby to the windowsill to see a bit of heaven shoot across the sky. The one and only time Daddy saw it fly. Well, it came from the east just as bright as a torch. Neighbors had a party on their porch. Daddy rocked the baby, mother said amen. When Hallie came to visit in 1910. Now back then Jackson was a real small town. Not every night a comet comes around. It was almost 80 years since his last time through. Guess your mother would have said amen too. As his tail stretched out like a stardust streak, the papers wrote about it every day for a week. You wonder where it's going and where it's been. When Hallie came to visit in 1910. And Daddy told the baby sleeping in his arms to dream a little dream of a comet's charm. And he made a little wish as she slept so sound. In 1986 that wish came round. Well, it came from the east just as bright as a torch. Saw it in the sky from Daddy's porch. Heaven they sent as it was back then. When Hallie came to Jackson in 1910. And late one night when the wind was still,
song that is. It's a cool guitar line. John Jennings, fantastic.
Yeah. John Jennings, fantastic. And that song,
also fantastic.
Yeah. Mary Chapin, for me, is one of the formative artists. She's in the bedrock of my musical soul. And I don't think there's any artist that, you know, well before I was a musician or even contemplating this path, I would go to Mary Chapin Carpenter concerts like in the 90s, early 90s, just by myself. I didn't have anyone else who was into that, know anybody else who was into that kind of music. But also I just didn't want to be disturbed while I listened and just absorbed it. I remember going to all kinds of shows just to see her play. And to have it turn out, you know, finally to learn after Dave Carter passed that she had been a fan of ours, which I didn't know. I received a condolence email from her, like, I don't know, within a day of Dave's dying, and I thought it was a fake. I was like, who's pretending to be Mary Chapin Carpenter right now? That is not cool. But then it turned out to really be her, and she ended up playing, you know, a pretty big role in my recovery, in that she was very supportive of my Flower of Avalon work, wrote the liner notes for that album, sang harmonies on that album, lent me her band for some of that album. You know, we had John Jennings and John Carroll and
her.
Chapin herself singing along. And that's where you guys met.
That's right.
And during our sessions.
That's
so
right.
And then Jim Henry got to tour with her. And then it all came together in 2012 when you guys came to Falcon Ridge and Chapin invited me up on stage to sing Twist and Shout with you, which was like peak moment. That was so great. You were in the band and I was singing and John Jennings and I were doing a little jig off on the
side. Yeah, he liked to dance with girls.
Well, it was super fun. We had a fun. So, but equally formative for me is Sean Colvin. I'll never forget, it was, what year was it? 1994. And I was in Taiwan. I was teaching English as a second language for a 5-week program in Taiwan. I had just gotten my English degree. And I was in some little cafe somewhere. And I heard a Sean Colvin song. And hearing that familiar music, I had listened to a little Sean Colvin tape, like, all the way over on the plane, you know, and it had been kind of like my home music. And then to hear it in the cafe, I was just like, I'll never forget that feeling of like, oh, connection, you know, how music just can be such a comfort to you. And
are you in the right place?
Am I?
I don't think so.
Oh, I'm not.
Yeah.
Thanks for noticing. Yeah. I'm in tune though, right? That's
yep.
Pretty good. So we're going to try one of Sean's newer songs. I really came up through the Cover Girl album and the Steady On.
Well, newer, I mean, this is, you know.
I know, what is this?
10
probably,
or 15 years old, probably.
Yeah, I know. I sort of ducked out of popular music for a while there. But anyway, we're going to try this one. I've never tried this one in public before, so we'll see how it goes.
Are you ready?
This is Sunny Came Home. 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
opened a book and a box of tools. Sunny came home with a mission. She says days go by, I'm hypnotized. I'm walking on a wire. I close my eyes and fly out of my mind into the fire. Oh, Sean Colvin, Sunny Came Home. That's a fun one with the mandolin, yep. That lick.
Well, that's another song. It's just like the last one. John Leventhal? Does, you know, it's just as iconic as the song, as the lick.
Yeah, and it's not super fancy,
no,
but
it's
just
not. It's like it would be hard to imagine that song without it. Just Byers Approves.
Just Byers Approves.
Yep.
I loved it, too.
Well, speaking of Sean Colvin, did I ever tell you my Sean Colvin story?
You did, but go ahead and tell everyone else.
What?
I think you did.
I know. I don't think you're thinking the same one.
Oh.
This is before she, like, really hit. She had the cassette out. Sean Colvin Live. It was a live thing.
Mm-hmm.
And she was going to be playing, I think it was at Falcon Ridge. And this is before, you know, this is before Falcon Ridge got even really, you know, had like 10,000 people. This is like, she was one of the headliners. And I was out there with Bill Morrissey the day before, but I wasn't going to be there the day she was there. But I had this great idea. So I took her cassette and I brought it to my studio, and I took one of the songs, I forget which song, and the cassette was just her and her guitar, and so I wrote a part, overdubbed a part, and made a new, you know, a new demo of it, of that song with me playing along, you know, in hopes that, you know, maybe she needed a guitar player, something, always hustling, And I had a friend of mine who knew her, was going to give it to her. And then I never heard anything. But that that was my whole story.
So that was your sing-along with Sean, but she never knew it.
She never knew. And then she went on to be superstar. So.
And so did you.
I missed the train.
It all worked out.
I missed the Sean Copeland train. But then, you know, I got to meet her when I was playing with Chapin.
I got to meet her too, yeah. Isn't that funny? Got to meet our heroes. It's cool.
It's cool.
We're lucky.
All right. That's the wrong sound.
I'm going to back up from this mic a little bit.
This one's louder. Yeah, this is, I've always loved this song. Actually, I played it at my friend Bob's wedding. Hope we got the right key here. I don't know why the sky is so blue, and I don't know why I'm so in love with you. But if there were no music, then I would not get through. I don't know why I know these things, but I do. Don't know why, but somewhere dreams come true. And I don't know where, but there'll be a place for you. And every time that you look that way, lay down my life for you. And I don't know why I know these things, but I do. I don't know why. There you go, Sean Colvin. Lovely. A double header. Sean Colvin double header.
Yeah. So nice, Jimmy.
Lovely
well
song.
Done.
Lovely song.
Sure is. Lullaby. It's like a lullaby.
Yeah.
Well, this next artist is one that my brother was telling me for years, you should listen to so-and-so, you should listen to so-and-so. And I was like, okay. He's like, no, Tracy, you really like her.
Like, you know, your brother does not sound like that.
He does in my head. No matter what he says, he always sounds like, shut up, Tracy. It's a deep, deep imprint from our childhood, I guess. But no, he does still kind of sound like that.
Okay. I saw him in August. I haven't talked to him in a long time.
I saw him in August. He still sounds a little like that. But anyway, he was telling me, you know, I should listen to this artist, and I didn't for the longest time. And then, what was it? How did I come to really cross paths with this artist? Well, I think there were a few things that happened. One of it was, you know, my brother Jimmy's influence. And then I think we might have, you were covering one of her songs. Mm-hmm. And then I think I saw, there was this performance of her song, The Joker, or The Joke, on an awards show that just blew my socks off. And I thought, oh my God, I have to see who this is. And so I started looking into the work of Brandi Carlile, just to see what there was to see. And then I read her memoir. I went through a year of just reading everybody's memoirs. And what I found, what I really came to admire about Brandi Carlile's writing, in addition to her performance, is just how true her voice is. I mean, the book sounds just like the songs, you know? It's like, she's very consistent, and she's very a quirky writer, you know? Like, where I would consider Mary Chapin and Sean Colvin to be on the more poetic end of things, Brandi Carlile is more like, you know, she's more like the working people's voice,
right?
You know, real down to earth, real hard on her sleeve kind of writing. Nothing particularly coy about it or clever. Or, no, I'm not
what
gonna
you see
say.
Is what you get.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. And so we're kind of laughing about this song, because this song is just a love song about, you know, Brandi Carlile is basically just saying in this song, I don't need to ever go back to town, because I'm just happy with what we're building up here on the hill. And Jim Henry's like, it's such a chick song. But that's what I like about it. I like that it's quirky. I like that it's honest. And I like the voice. And I love her, you know, she also writes these wide open choruses that are just a real fun to sing.
You gotta print these lyric sheets bigger.
I know, I'm squinting
too. Tiny.
I'm squinting too. Oh, Kathy's asking how my mom is. We'll talk about that in a second. Or I could just say she's fine. Mama's fine. She's rocking. She's doing her thing. So, but we'll give you this one. I'll dedicate it to my brother, Jimmy, James Arthur, Jimmy Jr. This is called You and Me on the Rock.
Houses on frozen ponds in the summertime when the water's gone. Diagonal lines in their old out lawns, and the sage always smells so pretty. And nobody cares where the birds have gone when the rain comes down on Babylon. The stonemason's phone rings all day long, and you gotta get back to the city. I build my house up on this rock, baby, every day with you. There's nothing in that town I need. After everything we've been through, me out in my garden and you out on your walk is all the distance this poor girl can take without listening to you talk. I don't need their money, baby, just you and me on the rock. You and me 7 falling out of the sky. Folded them crooked, now I'm wondering why I always end up in the water. And nobody's asking why she's looking so thin, why she's laughing too hard, why she's drinking again. A fallen star in a gust of wind, she was going down when you caught her. Build my house up on this rock, baby, every day with you. There's nothing in that town I need after everything we've been through. Me out in my garden, and you out on your walk, is all the distance this poor girl can take without listening to you talk. I don't need their money, baby, just you and me on the rock.
A little rocker. That's fun to sing.
Yeah, nice little love song. Happy. Those are harder to come by, the happy love song.
Yeah. But she just writes about, I mean, she just, you read her memoir and then you listen to her music and it's like, oh, you suddenly realize where everything comes from. It's very honest writing. It's just, she writes what she knows, which is what everyone tells you to do, right? Write what you know. But, so I've really come to appreciate her work lately. And also her vocals and her stage presence, too. Really admire her.
And her clothes. She's usually got some good clothes happening.
Well, you know, she firmly believes that you do not show up in casual wear for your audience. She believes that they're coming for a show and you should give them, it should be a show from top to bottom. So that you got to have like some kind of quirky outfit. She's all about that.
You know, did I ever tell you about the time I thought this was going to be a regular feature of the show, actually. Did I ever tell you about the time? Speaking of wardrobes, this made me think of
it.
I was opening a show for Anne Murray from Canada. And she had her whole band with her. And this was at an outdoor thing. There was thousands of people there. But what made me think of the wardrobe is she had a wardrobe lady, right? Mm-hmm. To take care of all the bands and her outfits. You know, they had a whole separate thing. That's what we need. We need a wardrobe mistress.
To handle what, master. My 4 pieces of clothes?
Well, we'd have more. We'd have more stuff to wear.
Costumes.
Yeah, people could, you know, tend to our clothing needs.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway. Fascinating, right?
Well, you could have, we have that kind of in the plays and stuff, but yeah.
It's not the same.
Yeah, we don't have the entourage. We're just, you know, we drive, we pack, we play.
I guess I would
load up.
I'd rather have a cook, I guess, if I had to choose.
A cook would be the thing.
Yeah, I'm sorry, a chef. I'd like to have a chef.
Right. Wouldn't that be nice?
All right, well, here we are in this open dadgad tuning again. to visit another one of my very favorite Mary Chapin songs.
I love this one too.
I know it's just one of those songs. It's like Steve Earle's Goodbye. She's got magic in it every time.
And plus her vocal on the recording.
Oh my God! It's kind of, I hate singing it because I keep trying to hear her voice, and when I hear mine, it's just not the same. But I'll do my best.
You do it your way, Jimmy.
I'll do my best.
It's gonna be just fine.
I'll do my best. All right. Down in Carolina, I'm a detour on the ride for a phone call and a soda. I'm a blur from the driver's side. I'm the last gas for an hour if you're going 25. I am Texaco and tobacco. Dust you leave behind. I'm peaches in September and corn from a roadside stall. I'm the language of natives, a cadence and a drawl. I'm the pine behind the graveyard and the cool beneath their shade, where the boys have left their beer cans. I'm weeds between the graves. My porch is sagging lean with old black men and children. Their sleep is filled with dreams. I never can fulfill them. I am a town. Beside the highway, where the ditches never drain. I'm a Baptist like my daddy, and Jesus knows my name. I'm memory in the stillness. I'm lonely in old age. I am not your destination. Clinging to my ways, I'm a town. Up on cinder blocks, missing all my wheels. I'm Pabst Blue Ribbon American, and Southern serves the South. Tucked behind the JC signs on the rural route, I am a town. I am a town. I am a town, southbound. Song.
Indeed. Well, it's kind of the Mary Chapin Love Fest today.
Yep, we got a lot of her.
We do have a few. We've got two more songs to go, and one of them is hers.
So. Well, what happened was when we were first talking about it, you and I, we said, well, you said, let's do Chapin, Colvin, and Carlisle.
I know.
And then I said, well, but wait, what about Dolly Parton?
And then I was like, oh, what about Kate Wolf?
Yeah, so. Yeah, when I was first thinking about it, the Chapin tunes came up. Anyway.
Yeah, so this is one. This is one of her more recent songs that speaks to me personally. She's so good with the introspective. We're not playing any of her upbeat stuff like Twist and Shout or, you know, I Feel Lucky or anything like that today. I just resonated with this one personally, and I love the guitar part on it. It's really fun to play. I wouldn't say it's like super, super complicated, but it's a little, you know, pay attention. Dedicate this one to all the introverts in the house, for whom I'm sure the live stream is just the perfect way to go in terms of a concert. So I put the check information up on the screen there if you want to go that route, and then I'll put the PayPal. Oops. There's our little tip jar stuff. If you're moved to tip, we do these shows every month, last Tuesday of every month at 3 p.m. Eastern time, but of course the archive is always available. If you subscribe to our YouTube channels, either Jim Henry's or mine, we don't have one that we share. That kind of moves us toward the 1,000 subscriber mark, where I am told you can start.
Good stuff happens.
You can start earning money from the videos you post. Who knows? I'm sure those are pennies, but we'll take it. So subscribe if you haven't subscribed already, and then you won't miss anything that we post. This one here is just called I Have a Need for Solitude. Never be safe in crowded rooms. I like the sound of silence coming on. I come around when everyone has gone. I have a need. Verdant spaces beneath the trees, and secret empty places nobody knows, so no one will intrude. I have a need for solitude, but you can find me when the light is changing. At that time of day when there's little day remaining, and you can find me where I've been waiting, waiting here for you. I never was. Tough and cool, all I was. All my life it seemed is hard to love, and harder now to keep. But you can find.
solitude I'll never be. Safe in crowded rooms, I like the sound of silence coming on. I come around when all the rest have gone.
Chapin Carpenter, I have a need for solitude. Love that one.
Yep.
I never was fast, tough, or cool. Wah, wah, wah. Oh, well.
Well, not yet.
Yeah, probably not going to happen. Well, gosh, we're almost at the end of another live stream.
Brings us to another
just
live
one
stream.
More song for you. We want to thank you so much for listening, and thank you to everyone who is able to tip. We sure appreciate that. It keeps the lights on and makes it possible for us to offer these shows for free, or without a paywall, I should say. What do we have for? Yeah, right, Jane.
And now, was that like?
She's like, I feel seen.
I know, but does she feel seen in a good way, or does she feel seen like, uh-oh, when they found out?
No, she doesn't feel trapped. She feels seen.
I know. I understand.
So I'm going to let a little announcement. These are our things that we have coming up. My play. I would be remiss if I didn't mention my play.
Yep,
if you're in the Pioneer Valley, if you're anywhere near Westfield, Massachusetts, come to the Westfield Theater Group's presentation of Marvin's Room, October 14th, 15th, 21, and 22. At the Westfield Women's Club, we're doing 5 shows. It's coming right up. We are madly preparing for it. In fact, I'm running off to a rehearsal right after this live stream, which is very exciting. But do come see it. It's a kind of a drama and kind of a comedy about what happens when estranged family sort of is forced to come together again to confront some hard circumstances. So it's a deep, dark, but also delightful play. It's got a lot to offer. So,
all right.
Yeah, and then our November 20th, you and I are playing at the Parlor Room in Northampton.
Oh, that's right. Yes, we are. November 20th.
Coming right up.
That's right.
Some hockey calendars.
I got a few things coming up with the Deep River Ramblers.
Yeah, I asked you to tell me. I would have put them on the thing.
I forgot. We're playing in the Ludlow, Celebrate Ludlow.
Oh.
Ludlow, Massachusetts.
Lovely Ludlow.
On the 15th.
Oh, cool.
On the 15th in the afternoon. Yeah, that'll be fun. Anyway.
I guess you won't be coming to my play that day then.
Probably not that day.
Okay.
Yep.
We'll figure it out.
All right, should we play one more song here?
Let's do it.
Another Brandi Carlile tune.
Yeah, what drew you to this song? I've always been curious.
It was one of the songs I heard on the radio, and I was like, I don't know if I actually stopped the car, but I was like, damn, I like that song.
Just because it was fun.
I just love the song, yeah. Well, it was, there's a couple lines in here that just are fantastic.
Michael Galassi wants a TG Encore.
Yeah. Well, we're getting Brandi Carlile.
We'll see what we can do for you. What are we in?
We're in A.
All right.
Good for the fiddle. Well, Grandpa gave me a 3 penny and I put it in my pocket. I had big plans in my backyard to build me a space rocket. I talked to my brother on a fake CB that I made from a tic-tac box. I packed my snowballs nice and tight, and in the middle I put rocks. Now don't trade in your tic-tac box for the ball on the end of a chain. And
Don't go trading grandpa's pennies, buying in the game. 'Cause you got to keep your heart young. Oh, don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. 'Cause you got to keep your heart young. Now Grant took the wheels off my bike and he pushed me down a hill. But speed got the best of me and I took my first spill. Well, that was back when alcohol was only used on cuts. Stung like hell and I turned my leg, but mama said to give me guts. Now don't trade in your tic-tac box for the ball on the end of a chain. Don't go trading grandpa's pennies, buying into the game. 'Cause you got to keep your heart young. Now don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. 'Cause you got to keep your heart young.
Tear it up on the chorus.
Take a picture of the one you love, put it in a locket, and go dig up your time capsule and the blueprints for your rocket. We'll keep in touch on a fake CB, that same old tic-tac box. We'll pack your snowballs a little less, type it in the middle. Don't still put rocks. So you got to keep your heart young. Oh, don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. You got to keep your heart young. And you got to keep your heart young. Sometimes you don't die quick, just like you wish you'd done. And though love can be a loaded gun, you got to keep your heart young. And you can't take back what you have done is done. You got to keep your heart young.
Yeah, that's a fun one. And though love can be a loaded gun.
Yeah.
That's a line right there.
Well, what do you think? Should we do a little?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, we can do one. What are you going to do?
I saw a mention of this song in the comments.
All right. Well, you're a woman writer, so I guess that qualifies.
I wouldn't say I'm my favorite woman writer, but...
Well, you're certainly a woman writer.
I am certainly a. One of many. There's so many more women we could have covered.
I know.
I mean, we could do women writers all year.
We probably should do another one.
Yeah.
We kind of got stuck in the seas there a little bit.
I know, right? All right, so we'll play you one more song. We'll play you one of my songs. One of my older ones. Or should we play a newer one?
No, play this one.
Okay. Because you're all good to go.
Yeah, I'm ready to go.
All right, here we go. You ready?
Yep.
La da 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 da. I didn't want to burn like this, so close to the bone. No muscle left to carry it, this black bag of stone. The August heat, the autumn rain, and a winter's face of blue, yeah. These seasons keep their spinning up, but there's no sign of you. There is no sign. Richard says the whippoorwill done taught him how to go. And I tell him death is just a dream. What do I know? 'Cause it's everything and nothing when the spirit cracks the sky. But flowers fold and go to seed, and no one questions why. And so I walk this burden mile of memory with you, the gentle arms of Eden, and the mountain gap. Thank you so much for the request, and thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. We hope you are well and happy and warm enough wherever you are, and we'll see you next month.
October.
If not before.
Maybe next month we should do a day of our own songs.
You know what?
It's been a long time.
That's what I was thinking.
There you go.
I was thinking we're going to do Jim and Tracy songs next time.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Get some requests in if you want, and
get your requests in, and we will comply. We will
play
our hearts
songs
out for you. All right, everybody, enjoy yourselves, and we'll see you again soon.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming.
I said end.